guess off of that we had to test out to see if it was good or not was Procreate. I'm Ryan. This is John. That's Andy. He's managing the computer. Procreate was first developed by Hewlett-Packard, and it was eventually bought by actually PTC for $280 million. That's a lot of money, because Hummer was actually just recently bought by a Chinese company for $150 million. So, I mean, it's pretty pricey. Uses it's mechanical aerospace, and actually use some electrical engineering on there. Sometimes they model like handheld GPSs or stereo systems. Its claim to fame is it's a history-free modeling software. Like in Proe, you have to everything is based on what you did before. For Procreate, actually, you can just like edit your model and have it not affect what you've already done. So that's kind of what they market. Some people buy it. It's also made by PTC. You can use all its applications that they have, such as Windchill and Mechanica. Mechanica is the program that you can like test out structures, like put forces on and see how it fails and everything. Market share. Now we did the same thing we did for Project 00. We typed in each program into the search. We got Pro-E, came up with 552 results. SOLIDWORKS, 1153. Google Sketch and Procreate, though, only have two. So it's kind of a small company right now, but hopefully it'll start growing, because it's relatively new. They just came out with a new version, so hopefully they'll try and push that version. Problems. As you will see in our demonstration, it has a couple of problems. First off, it doesn't run on Windows 7. Me and John recently upgraded, and we tried to download a free copy off the internet, and it would not work. I tried emailing PTC, seeing if I could maybe find a solution to that. They never got back to me. The download, I don't know if it was the computer that we were running it on or the actual download, but it's kind of poor quality. The tutorials aren't very helpful. And John has a 64-bit processor or operating system in the help. You go to help and nothing shows up. So that's kind of weird. And as we'll see shortly, it doesn't run well on a basic laptop in a system.
Alright, so we actually aren't going to do a live demonstration because this program is being such a pain in the butt. As you'll see shortly, we actually use a program called Camtasia to record our screen capture. So this took us 3 or 4 times to actually do this. The simplest part we could actually do to model. So this is just a video of us modeling the hardware. We'll start now. And just a lot of data like I was doing it live, but this is just a video representation. So this is our video. So Danny gets it going. It's very simple. It starts off again, modeling program should. However, you'll soon see that one of the main pitfalls of Procreate is the fact that every time you draw something, it immediately disappears. That rectangle I just drew is no longer there. Every time I have to draw something, you have to hit the fit button fit model to the screen so that you can see what you drew. It's a huge pain. It's like drawing in the darkness. Yeah, our rectangle's gone. The art tool also, we're actually doing the first solid modeling we ever did, which is that kind of U-shaped bracket of the holes inside. Really simple, just some rounds and connectors, but this took about 20 minutes, 3 or 4 tries, so it's kind of demanding. But I couldn't even get the art tool to work, period, because you can't see where the art's drawing to. So we had actually to fill in the drawing and go about it that way. But after a while, it seemed to work all right. 2D drawing is very similar to Procreate, obviously. It's just you draw 2D and then screw that sketch to me. That's all within this application over here, which is the machine application, which is that one I just wanted to. It's where you can get all your extrusions and your millings, which is just material from Procreate. As you see, again, it's disappearing. The model itself. It didn't look right when we were screwing it anyway, just a lot of sketchy and all that. And what I'm doing right now is actually creating a new workspace, which is another very interesting and kind of weird feature of Procreate. Every time you draw, or have to create a 2D drawing, you can't draw it on like a face of the object you put in Pro-E or just anywhere on a plane, a bigger plane. You have to create a new workspace every time. And it's not exactly a pain, but just it's every time you want to create a new drawing, you have to create the work, so it's just another step that isn't really necessary in any other programs, but it seems to be in this one. Right now I'm doing the extrusion to make the little U-shape in the middle. Again, I can't draw an arc, so I didn't make a rectangle and then sketch it and fill it in the middle, which is it's just another step that doesn't need to be there. Yeah, there's actually a lot of age for this video too, but it eventually ended up with a bunch of swearing customers, so we decided to take that out.
It's quite awesome.
Yeah.
It's on YouTube,
so you can see a lot of
it. Yeah, if you want the audio, you can go on YouTube with a bit of it. It's pretty funny.
We have an issue with that. But, yeah, so this is still a cut going on. I feel like if you model this part for me now, with all of our modeling skills, it's taking about 5 minutes first try. But this is, like I said, our third or fourth try.
So,
yeah. Now, the problem that will become apparent right now is that since you can't see any of the lines and you only kind of see them, I don't know if you guys can see this, but there's blue lines that are showing up when you slide your mouse over the already drawn lines. It doesn't exactly snap to anything when you're drawing a line appropriately. Like, it'll snap to that parallel feature that it should have been for me, but I want to snap to the point right there, and it doesn't highlight it or doesn't show me where it is, so you just have to kind of guess and then go from there. As you can see, I keep having to hit the refit button to see where my model is and keep it disappearing. But, like I said, we don't know if this is just the program we're running or if it's Andy's computer, but you could have tested it out on any other computers. You can have downloaded it on any ones. It doesn't run on Windows 7. So, all in all, it's just a big pain.
It was free, though.
Yeah.
You can get it free. It's free download.
And it's not, the company's free download. It's not like a Google copyright. But, it was the same.
Yeah, you can get this for free or you can buy one.
Yeah. And I'm finally going to connect the extrusion, hopefully. Oh, another thing. In making Pro Wii, you can zoom, rotate everything with just the middle mouse. You don't have to use any other options at all. In Code Create, there's not really a hotkey or a shortcut for that. You have to go up to that viewing panel at the very top and hit pan, hit zoom, hit rotate, all separate buttons. You have to cancel the button after you use it. It's not exactly user-friendly. It seems very archaic, I guess. Well, I finally made the extrusion, or actually the cut at this point, using the mill material, the material button. All these materials are very, or all these buttons are very similar to the Pro Wii's and naming and stuff for the most part. Although you can see some differences with reflect being the mirror option and turn being revolved, it seems to be dumbed down for more of an everyday user instead of an actual engineer. Right now I'm going to create the circles, the holes that go through each side of the part. And as you can see, it's kind of just guessing to where that hole will work at this point. That's the only line that will show up for some reason. So, now this is an interesting problem we ran into. I drew that circle on the first work plane, this green one, the top that was just highlighted. Just in ProBeat, you could have a model and then draw a circle or a hole anywhere in that part, and it'll just hold the object. In CodeCreate, if you draw that hole on your original model, it'll assume that you're trying to edit the 2D sketch that you originally drew. So that original, like, kind of, blob-shaped side view of the part, CodeCreate assumed I wanted to edit that part, so it took that circle I drew and then just inserted it into that 2D drawing, and that's why it extruded wrongly. It didn't shell out a hole, it just extruded the whole entire part over it. So this is the second attempt before I realized I had to make a new workspace. But again, you'll see that it'll fail. What should happen is the inside circle should be purple, and that should be the part that's being removed, not the entire thing. So right about now is where I realized that it's probably a good idea to, there's a customer there. There's where I should probably create a new workspace to make the hole. Because that's what would happen. As it's the default drawing circle on the first workspace. So I'm going to undo that command and draw a new workspace on the opposite face. It seems like a part of the process doesn't have to be there, to tell you the truth. It's just something unnecessary, and I don't know why you can't just edit. You can't really edit a 2D sketch in CodeCreate either. You have to either delete it or draw a new one. So, this is me creating another workspace.